So dear students, good afternoon, good evening. And I am DC Soni with the Indian Institute of Tourism and Travel Management, and I'm mainly teaching the tourism technology related subjects and management. I am basically a product of NIT Allahabad, and I was working in the industry for quite some time, and then I had joined this Indian Institute of Tourism and Travel Management for quite long back. Today, I hope, because as I was going through the schedule, your FAM lecture schedule, I found that one of my colleagues has already spoken to you on technology in tourism business. But some of the emerging travel and tourism industry trends I would like to discuss today, so that it can give you idea about what are the latest trends and in the tourism and travel industry. See, as we see, tourism and travel industry, it is a dynamic industry, it is ever changing industry, and there is a change in the need, tourism demand. What the tourism demand means, tourists, what tourists place their new demand to the industry, that is, we can term it as a tourism demand. So there is a ever changing trend of the tourism demand. There was an era of the mass tourism. People used to go in mass to destinations, and there was no versatility of the product. The kind of products, they were very similar or very same kind of products were available. Either it was related to sea, sand, and sun. But by the passage of time, we find that the nature of tourists has changed. They started working because, you know, when there was industrial revolution in Britain, in United Kingdom, the people started going to work with the industry, and that way they had a limitation of the time. So because the limitation of time, there was only one kind of possible tourism product, that was the mass tourism products. People used to go, and with the development of new transportation means like the railways and the airlines, there it also made more flexibility in designing the tourism products, like traveling to a particular place. Then initially there was a time constraint, but the time constraint was some of the factors were such, so they gave some leverage to the new tourists. The new tourists then demanded more flexibility on their tourism product. And new kind of societies also developed, the hippie kind of society or ding kind of society, yuppie kind of society. And because of that, suppose the ding kind of society, where double income and no kids, the people have a lot of money, they both are earning, and time is only the constant, but they have different kind of demand. They are clothes on, they want to immediately go and run for the experience. Now they want class tourism products. They want green kind of tourism, ecotourism, health wellness tourism, and many such kind of tourism has evolved. And this is just because of the changing pattern, changing scenarios, changing business climate. And this was in fact transformed with the advent of new tool in the industry, and that was the information technology, communication technology in the tourism industry. Information and communication technology with diffusion, what was its mandate? Why it was so inevitable to diffuse in the tourism industry? Because there was a need for it. Tourism industry, basically, it is a information intensive industry. Because it is an information intensive industry, the revolution of information that was only possible with the advent of the technology, that is the information technology, and today is the boom of the information. And with this boom of the information, there is a lot of quality change in the tourism product. Now there is a demand of tailor-made tourism product, which is possible with the technology. There is a demand for class products, which is possible with the technology. There is a complexity of business. Now millions of airlines, thousands of airlines, they are working with the millions of travel sectors. So if such a volume of the travel business is, then how we can manage this, such a complex travel business? Initially, you find that ticketing was a manual one, and with the manual ticketing, it used to take even sometimes a week for booking a ticket. But now today, with your fingertips, you can book a ticket. And so many changes have come across, the people have observed. So there is lot of entirely this tourism and travel industry has been transformed. And this transformation of the tourism and travel industry is basically, because of the diffusion of the technology. It gives the efficiency, it gives the quality, it gives the quality service delivery, it gives you immediately feedback, it gives you economy, it gives you tailor-made development of your products. So what not? Information technology. And now today is the era when the COVID has surfaced. During this COVID time, again, the role of the information technology plays very important. It's a very important role. How the people will meet this challenge of COVID time? But, because if there is a happiness, people have to travel. Just for the sake of happiness, people have to travel. And I would like to tell you some certain things, the emerging in travel and tourism industry, what are the trends nowadays, just we will discuss. Here, most of the people now, they have a palm top device, they have very handy device, that is our mobile phone. Mobile phone is such a versatile tool that for any of our day-to-day purpose, day-to-day activities that we immediately use for it. Say, whether it is commercial or it is for just, information exchange or, communication with our people. So many activities that we are performing because it is so handy and a very important, prominent tool inside it, that is the internet. Internet technology is so versatile that it is so indispensable for any industry, and that too for information, that too for the tourism and travel industry, it is a boon. So how the smartphone, they have come, there are several surveys made, like the people now for purchasing any travel product, they use smartphones instead of laptops or instead of the desktops. The smartphone, smart speakers, and artificial intelligence assistants, they have all helped to increase the relevance of the voice search. Now, see, we are talking about here first the smartphones, and then there is a technology called voice search. Speak for something and immediately it is on the screen of the mobile phone. So in particular, a growing number of travel customers, they are using the voice search to find and book airline tickets, hotel rooms and travel experiences. On top of this, voice control is also playing a growing role in the actual travel experiences too. Within the hotel rooms, the voice control devices can be used to control lighting and heating within the rooms, or to obtain tourist information without needing to speak to a member of his staff. And this is likely to continue to expand into other areas of the industry as well. So this is why search is an important tool, and that is in your hand, and that is why it is so popular. Most important thing is very, very user friendly. It has no limitation of your location, your physical presence, wherever, anytime you can raise your question. Another technology, that is the robot technology. The robotics technology is one of the most exciting form of travel technology, and it is constantly improving. You might have come across many examples how the robots are serving to the in the developed nations like Japan, for taking orders and serving the meals in the hotels. So many things are there. So and apart from it, not only COVID, this has already been taken into shape in the industry. Robotics technology is one of the most exciting form of travel technology, and it is constantly improving. Within hotels, for example, the robot, they have been used in concierge services, like the role helping to greet guests when they are arriving and providing information. Some hotels, they have expanded their use further till involvement them in the cleaning and the luggage handling. This is, in the advanced society has already been implemented, is being done. And quite long back, it has started, not only during the COVID pandemic time. See, my lecture has a flavor of the COVID pandemic reference. How this technology is helpful during the COVID pandemic if this climate continues. Within the restaurant, robots then potentially have a role in food preparation and food service. In airports, they can be used to detect the concealed weapons, while some manufacturers, they are also using the robotics to create luggage cases that intelligently follow you. Moreover, travel agents, they are using robots for pre-screening, making waiting time more productive for the customers. Here, as with many other technology trends within the travel industry, the use of the robot, they have actually increased the response to COVID, especially as they have the potential to reduce the human-to-human contact, which has an advantage of the robot in this business climate. Now, the next thing is the virtual reality. Virtual reality is sitting at your home. Sitting at your home, you can experience the outside world. Experiencing any destination at 360 degree virtual reality. Suppose you are, somebody is there who is not willing to travel down to Agra, but want to take the complete experience of Taj Mahal inside and outside of it. So this is the tool which can help you in, giving a true experience of Taj Mahal. Virtual reality has been emerging technology in a number of different sectors, but its role within the tourism industry is especially significant. After all, it provides travelers with the ability to experience far away locations from the comfort of their own home, and can be different the weather they ultimately complete a booking. See, there are nowadays many companies which are providing, with the help of this technology, which are providing the experience of worldwide destinations. And they are charging a handsome amount of money. If you go and search, in Google, you'll find these virtual reality companies for tourism and travel, tourism industry. Using virtual reality tour, the customer can experience everything from virtual hotel tours and restaurants to landmarks, national park, or even specific activities. The interactivity and the immersion can also help to provide you with the competitive advantage over the rivals who are not yet making the most of these kinds of tech trends. Most of the virtual reality tours, they are 360 degree tours. 360 degree that you can see the entire site, all corners of the monument. They are now compatible with the mainstream web browsers and can help those who are reluctant to travel due to COVID. Got the point. Now, the fifth is, again, that the, you know, artificial intelligent chatbots. Chatbots are very powerful tool nowadays for the tourism industry. Artificial intelligent power chatbots, they can be one of the single most sensible travel technology investment you can make for the promotion of your business. Because these chatbots, they are able to provide customers with the swift answers to questions on 24/7 basis. This is the magic of these chatbots. Regardless of the staff availability, important thing. And this can be essential for living up to the current expectation of the customer service. Amazing thing, AI chatbots. Typically, these chatbots are at their best when they are answering common questions, which have standard answers. See, naturally, garbage in, garbage out, whatever the kind of general expected questions are there, certainly those kind of answers, they are fed in the machine. And, you know, yet advances to the artificial intelligence technology mean modern chatbots continually improve as they have more and more interactions. They can also be especially good for the response policies and safety of the hygiene measures. Yeah? And then cybersecurity. The cybersecurity, you know, see, most of the business is now in the cyberspace. The electronic marketplace is there, where e-commerce, you know, people are buying and selling. There are B2B business, B2C business, C2B business, and government to business, government to customer, government to client, and so many. There are so many kind of models nowadays in the cyber space. So electronic marketplace, its safety and security becomes very important. The cyber security measures have been beefed up, and you know, new algorithms based theories that have been written. And nowadays, there is, you might have heard, you know, day to day, there are several threats from the enemy countries to you know. So this is a major challenge which has been taken up in the priority, and scientists, the technology scientists, they are doing computer science, they are doing many new things in this area. Cybersecurity is a major focus area for those in the travel management role, because the companies in the industry, they are the increasingly at risk from the cyber attacks, and also more vulnerable to data breaches of this kind, other kinds. The travel companies, they are the major target because they employ lots of people and they have access to abundance of customer data. Because data, big data is a resource for everyone. No theft of data. It is a major challenge globally, because deep, big data is a new technology that people want to play with the data, and they want, after extracting data, you know, they are doing business on the data. Some of the biggest threat in this area that, you know, the very common terms, the phishing attack and the ransomware attacks. Although the modern reliance on data also level companies at risk for human error caused by their own employees too. This requires investment in cybersecurity, training, and the various hardware and software solutions to keep your business safe. So the cybersecurity measures, very important, which have been continuously been derived to a newer phase by the computer scientists. It is also important to keep up with the the latest regulation to comply with the data protection laws. You know, there are, you know, country specific laws and the international trade related laws are there. So on those, keeping, you know, on within those framework, these cyber security measures are taken. That's what it means here. Internet of Things is a new term that is called IoT. IoT technology, Internet of Things, IoT technology. And it is useful in tourism business. It is one of the most exciting emerging travel technology trends, that is the Internet of Things. And this involves internet-based interconnectivity between everyday devices, allowing them to both send and receive data. Already, we are seeing example of its role within the travel and tourism industry, and this is ongoing to increase. This is only going to increase in future because it's the latest technology that see, it is like, you know, giving a device that you can use for multi-purpose, for various purposes. For example, IoT technology can be used in a hotel room to provide a customer with a device that connects with everything from a light, from the light to the heaters and the air conditioning, allowing all to be controlled from one place in airports. Meanwhile, luggage cases can be installed with sensors that will alert passengers when they pass by. So you can just think of how IoT technology is important and how it can be in technology of the future. Got the point? Next thing is recognition technology. You know, this technology, like, you know, fingerprint, you know, your bio sensing devices. The recognition technology is especially interesting within this list of the key tech trends due to its potential for removing frictions from the purchases and making interaction seamless. Right, so the technology itself includes the fingerprint recognition, facial recognition, retina scanning, and the various other biometric identifiers. And you know, these are hello, are you able to hear me? Hello. In fact, I don't know when it got disconnected. Probably I hope that everybody was listening to me. You can send me communication through chat box.
So please share your screen.
Yeah, I'll share the screen again. But what I wanted is, have you listened to my entire deliberation so far? Where from I got disconnected? I don't know. I'll just say again.
Yes, sir.
The recognition technology? Yes, I was there?
Yes.
We done it.
Yes, sir. We have completed the recognition technology.
Right. Very nice.
Hello.
Yes, hello.
Sir, it's from recognition technology.
So please unmute yourself.
Okay, yes. Hello, are you able to hear me?
Yes, sir.
Oh, yeah, thank you. So recognition technology is especially interested, is interesting within this list of key tech trends due to its potential for removing the friction from the purchase and making the interaction seamless. It is most trustworthy. This recognition technology create trust in between the in the business for the customer as well as the entrepreneur. The technology itself includes the fingerprint recognition, facial recognition, and retina scanning in the various other biometric identifiers. Such technology is already being used in some of the hotels to allow accept access to room via fingerprints or to allow for contactless checkouts. However, in the future, it is hoped that this technology may be able to allow you customers to pay for meals in the hotel restaurants simply by walking through the exit. So how these technologies are being used these are being planned to be used in future in the various services in tourism industry. Augmented reality. The augmented reality, it is similar to the virtual reality as I have discussed. If anyone has any question, then what they can do is they can type in the chat box. I'll take those questions separately at the end. Augmented reality, it is similar to the virtual reality, but it involves the augmenting person's real surrounding rather than replacing them. Got the point? So one of the major plus point of this particular technology trend is that it is cheaper than virtual reality. Okay, and with users requiring only a smartphone or a tablet device which has access to the internet, this is the augmented reality. All right, so it is very easy connection to through a device, right? Through graphical overlays, those in the tourism industry can greatly enhance the customer experience, providing customers with the valuable information or even pure entertainment. For instance, app can allow for photographs to be augmented through filters and effects. Details about the local destination can also be displayed as the customer point their smartphones at them, providing information at the exact time and that it is most relevant. So this is the use of the augmented reality, which is almost like the virtual reality, but is a little difference that you can understand about. Next is the artificial intelligence, and this is the technology of the future forever. Artificial intelligence, the entire globe is going to be automated because with the using this technology, and that is why I call it as the technology of future. Most of the researchers nowadays in computer science, they are in the field of artificial intelligence. Developing new tools in every walk of life, every walk of every kind of industry. Artificial intelligence, so versatile area for business. Away from the ropers, artificial intelligence is being used other way too. Perhaps the most obvious use within the travel and tourism industries for customer service. With chatbots possessing the ability to deliver rapid response times to problems or queries, as we have already discussed in the chatbots. It is also able to continuously learn from interactions with the customers. All right. So in addition, the hotels and other companies operating in the tourism industry can make use of the artificial intelligence to accurately and continuously sort through data it will be able to draw conclusions about the business performance or trends associated with the customer satisfaction, and even intelligently managing the inventories. So this is the artificial intelligence, which if you are owner of a company, then artificial intelligence based systems, you know, I'm not talking about the medium-sized enterprises, I'm talking about the large-scale enterprises. So at that level, artificial intelligence systems are important for the company. Then a big data, I just mentioned previously also big data, and data is money nowadays. So in modern tourism management, a big data is a focus of life, and almost all companies that they are successful employ their own data collection and techniques. They collect their own data and then they manipulate, and then accordingly they do their market research and product design and and marketing. They do accordingly. So it is a very important tool for it, for business promotion. So one of the biggest use of this data is to improve the personalization, directly contacting with the client and keeping them loyal to the company. So this is the importance here. With the travel company using the information, they gather to make a specific adjustment to their offerings. What the point? Which is very important. Here the data is very important for, because if you are able to get any client who is revisiting you, it means your success of business is high. Another valuable use of the data is to analyze the current business performance. In particular, the hotel owners can use the big data for revenue management purpose, using the historic occupancy rates and other past trends to better anticipate level of demand. When demand is predictable, pricing and promotional strategies can also be optimized. So this is the big data technology, which I find most relevant. So these 11 tools I have discussed today, I hope you all have taken a glimpse of the technologies which are driving the tourism business globally and also in India. See, most of these technologies are globally available now. It is because the world is a small village, so all these technology you can find products available globally with the help of these. So I hope you got what I wanted to deliver, and if anybody has any question to me on other things, this session is open for discussion. Any question? I'll take a break for 2 minutes. What you can do is you can fill your attendance in between, and after 5 minutes, 5 to 6 minutes, I'll take a recap of what I have delivered, what I have discussed. So please fill your attendance, and I'll meet at 16:50 hours. Just a break of 5 minutes.
So shall we open the chat box by the time so as they can drop their questions?
Yeah, sure.
Okay, sir. Yes, students, the chat box is open in case if you want to ask a question.
See, there is a question emerging travel means. Emerging travel, okay, I'll just take your time. I'll start at, you know, 16:50. Yeah, people are asking for some break.
May I please request this person who is logged in with the name iPhone, whoever you are, if you can rename yourself, please, else stop participating. Either rename yourself or stop participating, please. By the time sir reverts back, students, you are writing your questions in the chat box. Apart from it, there are certain announcements. If you can please pay attention here for the announcements that we have. Sony sir, with your permission, I'll announce a few things that are scheduled for tomorrow.
Sure. Please go ahead.
Thank you so much, sir. Students, first announcement is tomorrow's schedule will have a little change. We'll be sending the changed timetable to you as soon as possible. Maybe by tonight we'll be sending the changed timetable along with the links. A director sir will be talking to you people for the first time, because like the last time when we had our inaugural director sir wasn't available that time. So our director, Professor Alok Sharma ji, will be addressing you people tomorrow. So the schedule will be sent to you. Along with it, there is one announcement. We are launching this new course, which is many of you during different FAM lectures were asking, like, what are the course options available, which languages we can enroll into. And I have shared this before also that we are about to start with a new language course. So we are launching this course, which is German language course. The flyer will be sent to you as soon as the class is over. I'll be sending the flyer of the German language course that we are starting. And in case of any query, in case of you people are interested, you may please contact the coordinators. So coordinators hain, unko contact kar sakte hain. With the further classes on Google Meet, I'm unable to understand this question. Anyways, so these two were the announcements. One was the launch of German language course, and the second one that there will be a change in schedule for tomorrow. That is, sir, will be addressing you people. Thank you so much, students. Over to DC Sony, sir. So whenever you are back, yeah. You may please answer the questions that are there in the chat.
Thank you, madam. Thank you, Ram.
Sure.
So there was a question, augmented reality. See, it is almost to the virtual reality, what I said. You know, the virtual reality experience sitting at home. And any experience, you know, around the globe, virtual reality, that these are the services under the virtual reality. Augmented reality is similar to the virtual reality, but it involves the augmenting a person's real surrounding. Okay, so rather than replacing them, that's what it means. There is a difference. One of the major plus point of this is, it's a cheaper technology. In fact, see, there's not much difference. And in virtual reality, you find that the, you know, the equipments are a little more costlier. Because you know the lenses and the cameras which are used in that, so that way, and that too, the technology which is involved, you know, when the networking or web based technologies are involved, then it becomes a costly affair. And whereas, you know, when once, you know, the augmented reality means, you know, including the person's real surrounding, then normally vice versa is the same thing as such, but there is no much difference on that. So through geographical overlay, those in the tourism industry can greatly enhance the customer experience, providing customers with the valuable information or even pure entertainment, okay, with this augmented reality. For instance, the apps can allow the photographs to be augmented through the filters and effects. I mean, these are the things that you can do locally. So this is what the augmented reality. Okay, and can you again explain about the big data for the revenue management? Yeah, big data, as I told, the data is money nowadays in the time of new era in internet technology. The big data is a management tool, management technique, in particularly in tourism management. It is a fact of life, I'm telling you. So the almost all companies, they are the successfully employ their own data collection techniques and how they use the data for their various purposes. As I told you, client records and taking their feedback and and then accordingly modification and transformation of the products and services as per the need of the people. So this is the importance of data. And another valuable use of data is to analyze the current business performance, how people are converting into business. People are coming, making queries, then converting into business. So that also can be calculated with the, estimated with the data. Well, lies the current performance of the business. In particular, the hotel owners can use this data for the revenue management purpose. Revenue management purpose, that's what data means, making them to revisit, enhancing your business. That is the, this is one. And another is the use of data for your back end tools. Okay, use of data for your back end tools for management of all your accounting and other purposes. So that it means here, the data for revenue management purposes. Okay, and my email is dcsoni@gmail.com. So dcsoni@iittmnoida.ac.in. So better if you have any query, then you can share with this iittmnoida.ac.in. yeah. And if any further thing that you can, sir, you can my email is dcsoni. I have already sent dcsoni@gmail.com. That is also there, but officially is dcsoni@iittmnoida.ac.in. And virtual reality experience, virtual reality experience matters. Yes, because the virtual reality experience nowadays, people have a lot of money. They don't want to, they have limitations and they don't want to go for trouble because of their limitations. So this is important tool for, the aged people sitting at home. They can experience the destination, virtual destination. And these are now popular things nowadays. Yeah, armchair tourism. That is also called armchair tourism. My email is dcsonir@gmail.com. Oh, you have taken note of it anyway. Any more questions? The third tool I had, you know, that is the contactless payment. There is a question from iPhone to everyone. I don't know what his name. And then Sarthak Chittis also says about that. So iPhone, you know that that is the contactless payment. It is the ability to accept contactless payment. It is important in tourism and travel industry, and this allows the travel companies to process payment more quickly, including the situation where the customers do not have access to cash. So their credit or debit card. This is, and you find, you know, most of the companies. Now they are, what you call nowadays, e-commerce tools are available in their website. They are e-commerce enabled websites. So almost, you know, the most of the, you see, there is a research data. In the research data, you will find that 50% of the sales of the entire globe, more than 50%, is through the cell phone. Almost 20% is through the laptops and the desktops, and merely less than 10% is offline mode. So this is the trend increasing. You see, since 2000 to this is now 2020, 20 years it has increased. E-commerce has increased multifold, even 100 times it has increased. I remember the data, and it is exponentially rising and ever rising, ever increasing, and that too nowadays in during COVID time. It has leaps and bounds, you know, it is rising. So the availability of the contactless payment that is started, this is just for the convenience of the people, because there is no time with the people. And it has emerged as, you know, as a key part of the travel marketing in the wake of the, you know, latest pandemic situations. Okay, so contactless payment, this is as much as possible, can also protect everyone. And this is the priority, you know, contactless. Yeah, there are people saying like want more topics on this. Naturally, we'll have more discussions on these topics, because I just gave you a glimpses on what are the technologies in the industry and how they are being used. Just I gave you a little idea about it. Okay, so that we can do. And thank you very much, everyone. And we'll meet in case you require more lectures, pan-India lectures, then yeah, there is no harm. We can have Google Meet lectures or, you know, Zoom lectures.